Hi, my name is Mike Hawes and I'm an application support engineer for Agile and Technologies. In this short video, I'd like to describe the NULL function and how that works with our DMMs to eliminate the lead resistance that we get when measuring with a 2-wire ohm resistance. So let's move to the whiteboard and I can diagram how that works. The diagram on the whiteboard shows how a DMM makes a simple resistance measurement using a current source and the internal voltmeter. If you're not familiar with this technique, please see one of the other DMM basics videos entitled How Agile DMMs Measure Resistance. To use the NULL function, we primarily want to do this when there are two things that are true. The unknown resistance is about the same value that our lead resistance, or it's close, and we want to cancel the lead resistance and only be measuring the unknown resistance. And the other situation is that this lead resistance must be consistent. We're counting on it being a constant value. So the way the NULL function works is when you're using the DMM, you remove the unknown resistance, you short the two leads together, and then you push the NULL button, and that actually makes a resistance measurement that includes the lead resistance of both leads, and that is remembered or retained in memory in the DMM. So that when you reattach the unknown resistor and make measurements, these lead resistances are subtracted from the calculated resistance. So again, using the NULL function, the unknown resistor is actually going to be the calculated resistance minus this NULL function. In our case, it's 2 times the lead resistance. So you've eliminated the lead resistance and have a more accurate measurement. Let's use the DMM and see this is how this is actually done on a DMM. In this short demonstration, we're using Agilent's 34410 DMM. And we have it on just the default power-up volts mode with the high and the low lead shorted with just a paperclip. So you can see in voltage mode it's reading a short. I'm going to go ahead and push the 2-wire ohm mode. You can see that we're getting approximately 1/10 of an ohm, 100 milliohms. But with just a paperclip, you know that most of the resistance is probably dropped across the leads. So let's use the NULL function. I'm going to head to disconnect the paperclip, and I'm going to short the two leads together. So they're shorted. And you can see there's only about 73, 74 ohms of this 100 milliohms are accounted for in the leads. So when I push the NULL button, you can see now it is nulling out and subtracting that 73, 74 milliohms, and we're getting pretty much 0 ohms. So we can now unshort, and we go overload because we're not connected to anything, but I'm putting the paper clip now on the leads again. So now we have the paper clip reestablished, and you can see that the actual resistance of that paper clip is about 11 or 12 milliohms. So this is a nice way of using the NULL function to eliminate the leads. If we want to stop using the NULL function, I can just toggle the NULL function again, and you can see now the value is back up, not quite up to the 100 milliohms, but it's up in the high 80s, 88, 89 milliohms. So this concludes the demonstration of how to use the NULL function for Agilent's DMMs.